The Ball Ring here on Radio Eastern Game Day. It's the big clash between Noble Park and Baldwin. And at halftime, it's Baldwin 12-3-75, leading Noble Park 6-5-41. And Jeff Gables is the leading goal kicker on the ground with four. Goss, three. Whilst for Noble Park, Kyle Martin, the leading goal kicker, with three. Can you see Noble Park getting back into the game in the second half?
Well, they had all their eggs in one basket with Martin to kick all their goals, and now he's in the middle. So I'd like to see how they've reinvented the forward line to see if they've got a chance, because if they can win it out of the middle constantly...
They don't have a forward line, man. It's getting to that stage now. But both these teams, times they've played bigger teams, have been found out forward of the footy.
So we're back in the middle. Pat Wright, senior oval. Rucks go at it. And it's Meeson who comes up with the ball, but free kick off the ball as the tackle came in on Gilchrist, now wearing the 88. His jumper got ripped off him, so his kick to the half forward line was chopped off, and Kemperman works it for the Bulls, hands it over to his teammate in Berte, who just spills it all the way over the line. And we've had a slow start to the third term, but in matter of fact, it's been a hot footy, and I think maybe the players still...
Slow start after 25 seconds.
I like it.
Well, to be honest,
we've got a number 93 out there, Will Taylor. Let us know what's happening there, please.
Gee, they're getting up in the heights. I wonder if we'll ever see a number 101 or something. That'd be good, wouldn't it?
So Gilchrist being 88, now we're looking for 93.
Get the binoculars on him. Where is he, BWS?
So ball on the outer side of the oval. Meeson does his own roving in the end, and the ruck for the opposition in fake gets it, and he can't get it forward for Noble Park. Tacklers come in, ball wrapped up again on the outer side, half forward for Baldwin. Rucks go at it again, tap one down, a big pack of players around it, and Martin is the one who claims it, dribbles it to half forward, but leading the race is the defence for Baldwin, and Goldsack takes it out.
Boundary.
It's crossed down boundary side, thanks to Lifecare, Will Taylor.
It is Luke Barker wearing number 93, of course his shirt got ripped off as well.
A lot of shirt ripping today, eh, Will?
Yeah, definitely.
A lot of girls hanging around the interchange bench.
Man,
as well.
Oh man.
It comes out now. Picked up there by Cadell. Got a little handball away. Loosely played there by Roach. He could have almost been pinged for dropping the footy there. Umpire said it was okay and we'll have a bounce. True centre wing position. Far side of Pat Wright, senior oval. 34 points is the difference. Baldwin, after a blistering 7-goal second term. Hold way, quick kick by Martin, found his teammate there in Keeley, who wanted to move things on quickly. The pops a ball up into no man's land across the half forward line. San Filippo got the handball away to Roach, and now he arches the back and has time to kick the ball up towards the wing position. The kick had to be good over the top of Lukey Barker's head and out of bounds on the full. So Tim Kelly looks like he'll be the recipient to restart play there for Noble Park. Backwards to go forwards, it's okay. Spotted up his teammate there in Jakey Wilson.
Got no one to kick to.
Now looking for the big target up on the wing position. Meeson got a big knock on that one. Now the ball spills out wide. Sanfilippo put his body on the line. So too did Anderson, forced it forward. Galante was there. Ferguson tried to get it back to Galante. He was on the ground, though. He was going nowhere. Weatherald is right there for a bear hug. And we'll have a bounce 50 metres out from goal.
But Ferguson is the one who plays on instinct that you'd love to see get involved now that Martin's not inside forward 50.
I think they need a lot out of Luke Mann in this second half too.
High throws it up now. Massive fist away out towards the Shepherd direction, and a bounce favourably for him too. That was as good as a kick, but his kick was an absolute shocker. And now Noble Park get the chance to drive the ball forward. Mann's got to stand up here at the back of the pack. It goes over all players. First player out there to meet it might be Harper. It was knocked away from him. Here's Rod Crowe on the right boot. Steady kick up towards the wing position. Good play there. Roach gets the handball inside to Chergwin. He'll want to swing around on the left boot. Does so now. Floats the ball up towards the half forward line. It wasn't a good kick off the boot, and over she goes for a boundary throw in. 34 points is the margin. 3.5 minutes gone here in the third term. Baldwin holds sway.
This is the same sort of issue that I saw earlier with Noble Park. They get the ball in, they bomb it inside, and it just gets run out so easily, and all of a sudden it's back at half forward for the other side.
Meeson taps it down from the boundary throw in, but the Rovers go at it and they tackle each other to ground, and the ball's underneath both of them. So the ball back in the hands of the umpire. 55 metres around from Baldwin's goal. They've snatched in a grandiose way a 30-point lead at half time after they trailed by 3 points at quarter time. And Noble Park, hopefully they got the answers from Mick Fogarty at halftime. They've restructured their forward line, but they still need to win it out of the middle. And it's contests like this that they want to get on top. But this time, it's Baldwin going inside, forward 50. In dispute, the punch comes in from the defence. At ground level, it's...
Great goal
around by Sanfilippo. Around the corner from 40, right boundary side, gets a goal. 13 on the board for Baldwin. They go to 13 goals, 3, 81. Leading Noble Park 6-5-41. It's a 40-point lead early in this third term at Noble Park on the Bendigo Bank scoreboard.
I know it's only early, Gav, but I tell you what, the signs are not good here for Noble Park. The way Baldwin are starting to run the ball out of the back line and deliver the ball into the forward line, it's starting to create huge headaches here for Noble Park. They've got to arrest it.
They certainly do, Brash. Fake went up in the ruck that time. They get the clearance, though. Noble Park, can they get the quick answer? Ball goes inside forward 50 in a super mark, taken over the back there by Ed McCutcheon. Wants to move on with it quickly, though. Put himself under a fair bit of pressure, but he had Sanfilippo there for support. Kicked a very fancy goal only moments ago. Handball over the top there to Weatherall. That's good. Here's Roach, who's had a very good game this afternoon. Roach one way, then the other, then put himself under pressure. I hope I didn't moz him. Came out Harper. He crawls the spoil. They kick inside forward 50, but nobody's home. Sanfilippo once again chops it off. So just slow things down here. Might use the social club side of things. Although that hasn't been the favourable side for most of the afternoon. Goes out wide. Churgwin takes the mark. Meeson screaming for it along the boundary line. That's ignored. Go back in towards the middle, towards Cross. That was certainly dangerous as the kick goes in now. Is looking for Martin over the top of him. Roach is there to mop up. On the right boot, swings it out wide, and now Jackson Weatherill will be able to mop up this one. Picks the ball up across the half back line, drives it up towards the wing position. He's always got clean skills. Goss takes the mark. He's kicked 3 goals in the first half. Brendan Goss switches the ball inboard. He was looking for Cadell, and he was held without the football, so the umpire said, give him a free kick.
How else was he going to spoil, though, effectively?
Goes up towards the half forward line. Goss, he made good ground then to get the ball back. Chip over the top. He just sits it up beautifully there for Blake Broadhurst. Lots of space to run into, and Broadhurst hasn't got amongst the goal kickers yet this afternoon. We'll have a shot for his first goal today.
Been reasonably well held by Peaver, right?
He's had a good game, Peaver.
Brendan Goss, after a reasonably quiet first quarter, though, he's been sensational in the last quarter and a bit.
Blake Broadhurst has kicked 25 goals so far this season. Leading the goal kicking for the Tigers.
Oh,
short
passes
cool. on though, and speak of the devil, Brendan Goss chimes in and takes a mark. He's got a difficult angle, but distance certainly won't be a problem. He's kicked 3 goals this afternoon and could equal Jeff Goebbels with 4 if he can put this one through.
I know the delivery probably hasn't done Goss any favours there, but it was the poor marking by Noble Park's backline there to even allow Goss to even get the mark.
Brendan Goss, what a super addition to the Baldwin side so far this year. Can he stick another nail in here? He makes a goal by work for that one. I'll tell you what, I thought it was going through, but he hits the pine on the way down with his sausage roll and a through for a minor score. 82 plays 41. They're double the score, the Baldwin Football Club of Noble Park, as we cross the 8-minute mark of this third term.
Kick out goes all the way to Plimmen, who gets the run going. They go through the middle, and on the Valente gets on the end of it, hands it off to Galante. Galante spears it in. Martin, he got in the hands to it, but he dropped it because it was a bit too fierce, and he gets tackled to the ground 40 metres out.
Might have been a bit unlucky there, Cole, not to get a free kick there. Ball play actually did fall over his back.
Yeah, it was. He was going helter-skelter, though, and you thought that if he wasn't, he probably would have pulled in that mark.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can get spectating the, even
just
watching Martin go for it.
Just need that little moccasin kick for him to run onto then, rather than just a little...
Yeah, he had his hands stiff over his head, just purely on the basis that it was going over his head at a rate. And now it's Anderson claiming it. Spins out of a tackle, but his hand pass has been sharked by the opposition. Sanfilippo sort of moves it forward, but the pack moves with the kick, and Anderson becomes the tackler 20 metres on as we approach the centre of the ground. And it's really now getting back to the contest and the hard nature of getting the ball and then clearing it. Noble Park hoping for the next goal. They desperately need it, but it's in the hands of Shepherd. This time he gets wrapped up by 3. So this is the time where Noble Park, they haven't scored since I don't know what minute mark in the second term, but it's probably been half an hour since their last goal. But now the rush comes from Roach. Roach gets his spearing pass towards Barker. Barker gets underneath it, but he's first back onto it in the pocket. Now in the right pocket, he's been tackled to the ground, and it's wrapped up.
Right on by Plymouth.
So Plymouth has been doing a lot of work with Johnston in the back line. Not only do they have to do the defence, but they've got to do the rebound. So the ball up 30 metres from the goal. Barker working around the ball. Now the umpire gives a free kick. This for the Noble Park fans. Thankfully, it's for you. And the cross goes to Ferguson. Ferguson, across goal, the kick went. He's going to spear it. Not really that smart. Monaghan gets his foot there to trap it. But here comes the ball, and Tigers coming onto it is Gilchrist in the 88. Gets it long and nearly to the line. The punch comes in from Wright, and Wright sees it over the line in the pocket.
He's been one really big winner, Peaver Wright, in the Noble Park back line. There hasn't been many, but he's been absolutely terrific on Broadhurst.
So the ball to be thrown in, deep in the ball and forward line, over the top there of both Ruckman. Barker went up for a Gossett, hands and knees, tries to release the football. Brighte was not letting him get out. Berte, I should say, in bright colours.
From Brighton.
Yeah, East Brighton.
Knock over the top there by Fake. Valuable distance there. Harper couldn't release the football. Back to the umpire, and we'll have a bounce about 40 metres out from the Baldwin goal line. They currently lead this game by almost 7 goals, 41 points, 82 to 41, after leading at quarter time. Ball scoots out wide. Goebbels, can he pick the ball up? Goes after it now. He's got two balls on his hammer and sees it over. She goes. Boundary throw in, 40 metres out from goal, Baldwin's end. Great crowd out here at Pat Wright Senior Oval today. The Bull Ring. Everybody loves it out here. Fantastic venue to watch local football. Kelly tried to break himself out of the Gilchrist tackle, or Barker tackle, I should say. And Pye says, give it back to me. We'll eventually get this right. Time on blown. 11 and a half minutes gone in this third term. They call the premiership quarter. We know that Baldwin's best quarter is their last, so Noble Park really have to start doing something. Kick there by Cadell. It was an up-and-under kick. Who's going to be the flyer? Barker was there, knocked away from him. Tregear, he didn't even look where the goals were, but he kicked it, and it fell short. Ferguson takes a good mark. Read the play well. Drives the ball out wide. It was a good kick out towards Monaghan. Couldn't pull it down on the first bite, and over the boundary line she goes. Well done by Jason Kennedy. They'll apply that pressure, and we'll
some
have
the
boundary
push.
Throw in.
It's every kick is difficult for Noble Park at the minute. There's not even that easy sideways kick out of the back line. Every kick is difficult.
Safe to say a little bit of luck would be handy for them at the moment, as Fake knocks the ball down. Little handball out there by O'Regan to Tregear. He'll have to use the right foot this time, but he's usually got just as good a skills. And Goss, who's in the front spot, has got good jukes, and he takes the mark about 40 metres out from goal. He'll kick from about a 50-degree angle.
Soupy. Got some stats there from Tuesday.
Noble Park leading the hitouts this quarter 12-7, but Bourne have been on top in the clearances, leading it 8-4.
So Brendan Goss, kicked 3 goals today. Going back to put through number 4. Safe to say if he puts this one through,
the fat lady will sing, will it? Or is that a bit early?
The pokies will.
Close.
Maybe Gilchrist will sing.
Kick comes in now from Goss, and the goal umpire does not move. Straight over the top of his head it goes, and that's Goss's fourth goal of the afternoon. He equals his teammate Jeff Goebbels with another 4 majors, and they are doing things very, very well. 14-4, 88 at the moment. They are the Baldwin side, and Noble Park 6-5, 41.
Yeah, the crowd's gone into a bit of a lull here. They're starting to sense that Baldwin are well on top here, and you know, it could get ugly if Noble Park don't start get back into the game.
Manson back in the ruck for Noble Park. He leaps as high as he can, but ground level, it's Gilchrist taking him from the centre. Into the corridor he goes, as long as he can. Now it's a contest for the push out by Noble Park. Only gets it to
Kennedy.
And Kennedy misses to the right, as he was on the right boundary side. For another minor score, they're 14 goals. 5-89, leading by 48 points. Noble Park 6-5, 41. And when I think about it, have Noble Park scored on the Bendigo Bank in about 30 minutes even.
Stewie Kemperman's coming off a bit gingerly there. Well, keep an eye on that, mate.
Anderson's in there, right on his hammer. There is Kennedy, won the football, got it back to Watts, who goes backwards again. That was okay. Sanfilippo, oh, he just had poise. Sanfilippo spotted up a nice little target there.
Oh, they're doing this at
you know,
will
Regan,
here.
And he just switches it across, and guess who? Goebel said, well, I'll have another shot on goal. I was the leading goal kicker up only a moment ago, and I want five. So he'll have a shot from about 50 out directly in front.
Is that sort of the case? Anything I can do, you can do better?
Last 11 scoring shots at this point to Bourne.
That's a damning stat 11. There, Az.
The last score, Noble Park, was 15 and a half minutes into that second quarter.
Okay.
Thanks to Choose Tap. Az doing a great job this afternoon. Write that down, Soupy.
Five marks inside, 50-0 this quarter.
Goebbels gets very close to the man on the mark. It's going to hold up. Manson's there. He couldn't quite pull it down on the first bite. Goes after it again. The big man. He's set upon by two Tigers. And we'll have a bounce about 10 metres out from goal.
I don't want to hear the stats. It's making me quite flat.
Well, you're feeling a bit depressed now,
yeah,
Gav.
I am, actually. The contest is...
15,
come on, Bulls, get up
15 minutes
there.
Gone. Manson knocked it down. That was okay. Good smother. Oh, out of nowhere. The kick goes up and under. A lot of players form around this football. Cody lost the pill, comes out now. Might be a snap on goal here by Kennedy. Bouncing football coming through O'Regan. Handball out wide. There's just players everywhere in the end. Can it get to the line? It was Barker and knocked on through for a minor score. Rush behind. And on the Bendigo Bank scoreboard, 16 minutes gone here in the final. Well, not the final term, the premiership quarter, the third term. It is 14 goals, 7.91, 50-point margin, 6.5.41.
Beach got the spoil in just in time, as the mark would have been taken in the goal square by Baldwin. So the kick out goes to the pocket. It's really stolid stuff.
Boundary.
We'll go boundary side for Lifecare Croydon as Noble Park just playing around with it. So Will Taylor, tell us what's on your mind, mate.
Yeah, Stuart Kempman just came off a moment ago. It looks like it's just a bit more of a soreness than anything at this stage.
So the turnover and shoot as they try to go forward, and now it's resulted in O'Regan getting the mark on his own in the end, just outside the 50. He'll kick, but he's not only got the distance, he's got the angle to try to beat, as the runners try to get around him from the back to get him some help. But he's going to spear a pass in. There was a few hands in the way, but it goes through everyone. And now it's on a contest at ground level where Baldwin seemed to be the man on the spot. Barker turns it around the corner and misses to the right. So for all the Noble Park in the corridor, it got to Barker, who missed to the right. For another minor score, we are now Baldwin 14-7-91, leading by 50 points over Noble Park, 6-5-41. 17.
Well, he's all over the joint here, Robbie Kemperman. That was a solid bump he received there.
We've played 17 minutes, third term, as the kick out goes to Noble Park.
Tim Kelly goes towards a Manson direction. Monaghan went up. It went through, clean bowled him. Ball went backwards towards the direction of Goldsack. They're across the half back line here, and they'll go deeper even still. Here's Cherguin. Takes it. He's the lone man inside the defensive 50. Spots up Shepherd across the half back line. He'll once again switch the play into the middle of the ground. That's okay. Weatherald, hasn't he been good this afternoon?
Oh, yeah.
Switches the ball out wide. Getting down
so
low
this
there
guy.
Was McCutcheon on the right boot. Wants to move it on quickly. Pendlebury takes it back to Weatherald. Just playing with them across the half back line at the moment. They've got the numbers, a kick into the middle of the ground, but Martin had the turn of speed to get in there and take the mark. What can he do? Who's presenting up forward? Kyle Martin sends the ball inside forward 50. It was a good-looking kick. Watts got down low. That was got up high. That was good. Sanfilippo at the fall of ball palmed it off to Pendlebury, and now he wants to switch it out. It's a dangerous kick out towards the direction there of Cross. He had three balls to beat, and the three balls went out. Little handball there by Keeley. Got it away to Ferguson on the right boot. Shot passes on, and Monaghan will have a shot on goal 45 metres out for the Noble Park side. And geez, do they need this.
They certainly do. It was a rare mistake by the ball and back line, just kicking to a one-on-three, and Sean Cross tried really hard there to get the ball in to get a stoppage, but unable to, and Noble Park get a turnover, and Monaghan kicks for goal.
He's already kicked one goal today. This is a very important kick. Can he squeeze this one through? He certainly can. That's his second goal today. And Noble Park have seven. Bendigo Bank scoreboard, 18 minutes gone, 7-5-53. But they're still trailing by a very, very lofty margin.
So that breaks 13 scores in a row by Ballman there. That's monstrous. 13 scoring shots
seven,
in a row.
7-5 so. Is 47.
Yeah,
isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah. It's tough, though.
I said I've only ever done further maths. I didn't do accelerated. I didn't do math methods. And that scoreboard is doing my head.
Yeah, exactly. That'll beat anyone. As the ball's back in the middle of Pat Wright Senior Oval, it's fiercely contested. Martin has to get his hands dirty. He does. He hands it out to his teammate in Plymouth. Gets it onto Anderson. A lot of contest here. Valente up and under. Harper comes from the back, but he had a metre to gain, and the defence holds up there again for Baldwin, so they'll clear. It's in the hands of Kennedy. Kennedy gets a short to an unattended man who drops it, and then he gets tackled and is holding the ball. And Kettle has to hand it over. And it's Cody in the 20. We haven't seen much of him, so I just hesitated. And he's looking for options. 70 metres out. He'll spear a pass straight to Watts, but he drops it. He probably had too much time to think about it. But he's got help. And Anderson needs to come in for the spoil. He's good at ground level.
Well
he gets
done.
The ground level. But it's all Tigers with Tregear getting a quick kick under pressure. His handball's been sharked. It's now big pressure. Cody gets it finally, gets it into 50. Fake will mark it. He'll drop it on the second grab at it as he ran into it. And he drops it over the line. So just when you thought they'd take mark inside 50, fake. Well, he just couldn't pull it into the bread basket, so he'll have to do the ruck. Noble Park getting some inside 50s now. At ground level, Bertay. He goes to ground, allows Baldwin to put the pressure on. Shergren helps out his defence, gets it to his teammate in Goldsack.
That's
he splits
easy.
It out
yep.
right. And Meeson gives it to Cross. Cross got
great
the... Ferguson came in late and smothered the ball to keep it inside 50. And this is more like we saw in the first quarter. Forward pressure actually applying real pressure.
But they're going to try and get some scoreboard pressure now as well, Gav.
So the ball in from 40 metres out. The rucks go at it at ground level. It's under feet. Ferguson again puts his head over it, gets tackled legally, and the umpire will come in and ball it up. So the status of the game at 21 minutes in the third term, it's Noble Park 47, trailing Baldwin 91. Umpire will see it go over. Everyone looked around and said, is there a free kick going to be paid? No. Out of bounds at 55 metres around from the goals. Important time in this game. If Noble Park have any chance of surging, they need to get the next. Martin's the man for goal number four. Runs onto it, puts it out right, and it stays there. So another minor score. It's 48 plays 91 on the Bendigo Bank scoreboard.
Weatherald, short passes on. Goldsack. Back line for Baldwin's just worked so well together today. Short option, Pendlebury, and has the knee led from the front. Gets it out wide. Mark's been taken there by Cross, who's also been lively. Drives the ball up towards a wing position. It was a two-on-one situation. He was looking for Goebbels. Picked up there by Robertson. Little handball over the top was okay. Noble Park still under a fair bit of pressure here. Kelly, he was just wasn't helped out by
yeah,
any teammates
tackle.
Then. And a fantastic tackle by Christian Sanfilippo to win the free kick about 80 metres out from the ball and
goals.
A
free kick
down the field.
How do you do
it's going to Noble Park.
It's going to Noble Park, so
shouldn't.
It might...
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, switch over in the middle, and I'll talk about turnovers. Here's one here, and now Baldwin, they're going to link up here. Sanfilippo was in there. He was trying to get it. He'll get it eventually here now. Off one step, Sanfilippo, can he put it through? The big chuck stands true. The Noble Park in the gold square, and Manson takes the mark. Short option, he's on. Brashaw almost had a conniption.
Yeah,
it
made me nervous.
Valenti takes the mark. Drives the ball out wide towards the Harper direction. Knocked away from him by Pendlebury, who's just spoiling everything and taking everything at the moment, one way then the other. Gets the handball away to Chergwin. Up along the wing position he goes. And it had to be pinpoint accuracy, and it was. Mark's been taken by Kettle. Wastes no time. Drives the ball inside ball 50. Here's Broadhurst. He hasn't kicked a goal yet. He'd love to kick an absolute
rebound.
Big
yes.
fly over the back by Goebbels, who just had the stronger jukes in the contest. And he takes the mark just outside the 10-metre square. And both players getting up quite gingerly in the end. It was a good contest. And just a little bit of a knee there by Jeffrey Goebbels has made Jakey Wilson feel it. But Goebbels will go back and have a shot on goal. He's kicked four goals this afternoon. And you can as good as write this one down, Grant Super Campbell.
It's now 7 marks inside 50-1 this quarter.
Thanks to Choose Tap.
Which way?
Well,
I'm joking.
Ballin's away here.
Keep him on his toes. That's what we like. Jeffrey Goebbels. Well, I've already put it down in my book. I don't know about everybody else. Straight over the goal umpire's head it goes. Goal number 5 to Jeff Goebbels. And, well, after Noble Park managed to snag one back 5 minutes ago and we were hoping maybe they could get a little bit of a run on, the quick answer, well, the answer came eventually, didn't it? And it's over 8 goals the margin here, 15-7-97. It's a 50-point lead. Noble Park, 7-5-47. 24 and a half minutes gone in the third term.
It's just Ballin have been terrific. Absolutely. The way they move the ball from their half back line is unbelievable. The way they found their way out of pressure here, down there, worked it beautifully. Terrific work from Goebbels too. He's been brilliant.
As trying to work it out of the centre is Berte. He's got some help from Valente on his hands and knees. Hands it out the back to Kelly. Kelly gets an up and under to centre half forward. The spoils come in at ground level. First running onto it will be Roach. He just bundles it forward. So he had some pressure with Kelly on his back.
He's like a cyborg, that Tommy Roach. He just runs. He's got one of the hugest tanks I've seen for a bloke at this level of footy.
He might be in the nominations for votes, don't you reckon?
Oh, yeah.
So ground level again, it's Berte getting into the contest in this third term. But he's not going too far with the tackler right on his back.
Player of the day winning the Trojan Hand Tools Workhorse Award, which is a $150 toolkit.
Manson claims it out of the ruck. Gets his kick to centre forward, drop mark by the defence, but it's still in dispute at half forward and goes coast to the line, and the line again will see it over. Tell us about the toolkit.
Oh, it's fantastic, Gav. $150, and it's got swift blade hacksaws, turbo knives, claw hammer, screwdriver, piler set, adjustable wrench, scissors set, tape measure, you name it, the toolkit's got it.
How do you use a wrench? I don't even know what those things do. But I reckon that'd be handy, and it's handy. The Baldwin have got the ball on a string at the moment, but Ferguson gets in the way. On the wing, he's been tackled as soon as he gets it.
If I need anything built, I call Brucey and he comes around and fixes it for me.
As again, the ball's in dispute, but it's been
That's
knocked.
That's a long flight.
I'm talking back in the day.
And it's out of bounds on the outer side of Pat Wright Senior Oval. Let's look at the score. It's Baldwin 97 leading Noble Park 47. And we'll get
48.
Should be 48, someone's telling me. We'll work on that later. When the umpires converge.
Don't mess with Will when it comes to the scoreboard, I can assure you of that.
Yeah, I've got 7-6 as well.
Okay.
So.
It's like a game of numbers here. We're comparing notes. As the ball goes down at ground level, where Noble Park trying to burst out of the pack, Berte finally does. Gives it back to the ruckman in Manson, who just puts the torp in. At ground level, Harper's got it, 30 metres on the bounce, picks it up, tries to hand it to a teammate running into it. Now eventually there is, and it's a goal to Gollis. Collis, and Collis lets us down. As he ran inside, he put the ball on the side of his foot to bend it, and it went spearing out to the right to be a minor miss. So that's 7-7-49, Noble Park, and a trail ball into a 15-7-97, 27 minutes gone, third term.
I think when you look at this Noble Park setup, if Ziggy and Shane Allen aren't playing, they're in trouble.
Well, it's safe to say they will be for the rest of the year, so we'll let this one go. Gilchrist takes it in the middle from cross, on little skew-if kick out off the side of the boot, out towards the Goss direction.
He still
wins the football. Chergwin ducked himself into trouble, dropped the football. Probably should have been pinged there.
Free kick to Chergwin. Holding the man.
Everyone helping you on that one, BW.
Special. Well, I actually thought he dropped the football there. I think he's incredibly lucky to have been awarded that free kick. Handball away to Weatherall, drives the ball inside forward 50. No one really went up for it in the end, and I think it's going to be a free kick to Broadhurst, who
seemed like he was
shepherded out of the contest.
Oh, looked like a bit of tunnelling there for BWS.
Yeah, spot on there, Brash. Broadhurst, who's certainly been lively in this third term, up inside that arc. He wants to get amongst the goal kickers. He hasn't kicked one yet this afternoon, and he'll have the last kick of the quarter as well from about 45 metres out, 45-degree angle. He's kicked 22% of his team's goals this year before this match, and he's kicked 25 majors. So he's been averaging almost 4 goals a game. A bit of ballerina work happening out on right in front of us here in the broadcast position.
It's the in-stadium Entertainment.
Broadhurst goes for goal. Can he sneak it home?
How's that wing?
Just faded at the last moment. Almost went over the post in the end. And the right result has been paid. One behind to the Baldwin Football Club. Bendigo back scoreboard as we are at three quarter time. That quarter went for almost 29 minutes. And it's the Baldwin Football Club surging ahead in this one. 15 goals, 8.98. Noble Park 7-6-48, so a 50-point margin. We saw that margin right throughout that quarter. Four goals each to Brendan Goss and Jeff Goebbels. Two goals to Lukey Barker. Kyle Martin, who started off on fire, has three goals for Noble Park. Do the Bulls have a yelp? Only time will tell. We'll cross back to Barry Cotts in the Radio Eastern studios, and we'll be back with all of what happened in the third term and what's going to happen in the final term right after this.
The inside of a cake can have many...